Despite popular culture and the public image, paleontology can be difficult, unglamorous, and at times, seemingly boring. But with a good dose of patience, paleontology can be rewarding, fun, and very exciting. Carthage College paleontologist Dr. Thomas Carr, along with student crews and Museum Curator of Education Chris DeSantis, have traveled out to the Hell Creek Formation in Montana. This short film captures part of their real-life search for dinosaur fossils and shares what a day of paleontology is really like.
Paleontology is the scientific study of life in the geologic past, especially through the examination of animal and plant fossils.
We have been waiting a full year to go back.
To go about understanding fossils, we need to first dig them up out of the ground so that we can study them.
Normally, this is a very long and tiring process, but lucky for you, I've been able to join Dr. Carr and his Carthage student crew on a few digs, so the hard work is already done. And in this short film, we will share some of the experiences we go through on a typical dig.
Now we can finally get onto the field. This is a very significant moment for us, as we can actually do what we've been waiting to do for a year.
And because the Dinosaur Discovery Museum is so focused on dinosaur evolution, you'll see those are the fossils we are after.
I have learned a number of things from Dr. Carr on these digs.
I'm up.
One is that we have to start our day early because it gets way too hot to work in the afternoon.
Do you want coffee?
Please.
Black?
We also have to leave camp with everything we need, so there's a lot of prep work to be done. When we have all of our equipment, along with plenty of food and water, we are ready to head out for a busy and safe day.
There are three major parts of a dig. The first is prospecting.
Hey, look at that.
I've gotten these untangled.
Look, prospecting is looking around or carefully observing your area for bone-like objects. Walking around the hillside, we look for scatter or possibly just a single bone or fragment.
This is what I consider scatter, and what we do is we follow it up. And there's more bone up there, so who knows, it may continue further up.
If we find something of interest, we look at it more closely. We carefully dig around the object, exposing it without harming or disturbing it.
That's a rock.
Yeah.
It's sandstone. That's a rock.
Well, yeah. I might have found something else. It looks exactly the same. Usually, this growth won't be hanging on to a rock. It'll be hanging onto a bone. So I'm not sure. I think I should ask Eric to come over and take a look at this. Yes?
Maybe?
Yeah, I think so.
Nothing like it.
Well, yeah. This is usually the indication to me, is this growth on here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's a piece of bone. It's definitely a piece of bone. Once something is identified as a bone, we start a process called quarrying.
Quarrying is digging around the fossil to expose it and to see if there are other bones around. There are very important parts of this process, including first marking the object's exact location. We do this using GPS. This ensures that we always know precisely where the bone was found. Then, as much dirt as possible needs to be removed without disturbing the bone. We then apply coats of a liquid plastic called Vinac to stabilize the fossil. The site is also mapped before removing any bones, which helps pinpoint their relationship to one another. And this brings up a good point. During a dig, we log or take notes on everything. It is important to have documentation on all aspects of fossil digs.
I'm just kind of taking some notes on what we did yesterday. After the fossils are stabilized, GPSed, and mapped, they are wrapped in a messy but sort of fun process called jacketing.
Jacketing ensures that each specimen is protected as much as possible. We encase the bone inside a plaster jacket. When the top half is dry, the fossil is rolled over and the jacket is completed. The jacketed fossil bakes for about a day in the sun and is then ready for transport.
Some jackets get very heavy. We had to carry this one back in the evening to avoid the heat of the day.
This step-by-step procedure of a typical find, prospecting, quarrying, vinacking, mapping, jacketing, and finally extraction, aids in not only preserving the bones, but preserving and understanding what the bones and their location can mean.
So I'm definitely ending on a good note. It's pretty exciting. I mean, anytime you find any little thing, it's exciting, but being in the same grid with the portion of the femur we found last year, that's pretty exciting. Pretty exciting.
After long hours of digging, it's time to call it a day. We make sure our fossils are covered to protect them from the weather so we can pick up where we left off. We grab our personal items and head back to camp.
Like any important undertaking, patience is key. And experiencing paleontology for a day hopefully demonstrates that patience has its own rewards.
Great first day.
And when a discovery is made, if the work is done and the right steps taken, that patience pays off.
Hey, science is not boring. Check it out.